for any Varsi superior. And who can be more superior than Krishna, the Supreme Personality of Godhead? He is the Supreme, Absolute Truth. Nitya Nityanam Chetana Chetanana. So Kunti has all along very selected words he used that we should learn. That is the injunction of this adha. Uttama Sloka. Therefore, Krishna Janada's name is Bhagavati Uttama Sloka. Bhakti Bhavati Naishthiki. The best one. Actually, if you love somebody out of love, you cannot use anything, means any word which is not very much appreciated. So, and they are all applicable. It is not like the logic, kana chelen nam paddulocho. One man has got a child who is blind, but he has given the name Padmalochan, lotus eye. Not like that. The selected words which Kunti has used, it is not improper. They are properly used. Just like here is one word used, Vaikuntha. Krishna's another name is Vaikuntha, or God's another name is Vaikuntha. Vaikuntha means Vigata Kuntha, Jasma. Therefore, spiritual world is called Vaikuntha. And the material world is Dukkhalaya Masasatam. It is not Vaikuntha. You cannot even walk without anxiety. Just like we are walking on the street and the leg slipped. So we should be very much careful. Even in walking, beginning from your morning walk, you are full of anxiety. But Vaikuntha means no anxiety. No anxiety. That is spiritual work. We must understand what is Vaikuntha love and what is Jara love. So, here everywhere simply danger. But if we take shelter of the Vaikuntha, Krishna, samasita ji patapallabam plavam, it is just like the boat for crossing over a furious, dangerous ocean. Krishna's lotus feet is compared with very sound, secure boat. And boarding it, you can cross over the ocean of nisayas. Babambudhi vatsapadang. Babambudhi. Ambudhi means sea. And bhava means the repetition of birth and death. Birth and death. Just like in the ocean, you are struggling, sometimes you are drowning, and somebody helps you, saves you from being drowned, and again he throws you in the ocean, then again struggle. So our life in this material world is like that. We are struggling from the very beginning of our life. We are simply struggling. We learn from Srimad Bhagavatam that after the sex between the man and the woman, the man injects the semina within the womb of the mother, of the woman, and it is emulsified first night and immediately forms a pea-like form. That pea-like form develops. So as soon as it is developed, of course, in the process of development, there is no consciousness. That's like deep sleeping. It is like that. But as soon as the body is little developed, there are nine holes, two nostrils, two ears, two eyes, one navel, one genital, one rectum, these nine holes develop, then the consciousness comes back. And when the consciousness comes back, then he feels pains and pleasure. Because when the body is developed, the body is very delicate, so he is forced to live within urine and stool and so many secretion. And there are always worms in the stool, in the urine, and they take advantage of the delicate body and they bite. So the baby, packed up, cannot move, cannot say anything, but feels pain, therefore moves. And the pregnant woman, therefore feels that the child is moving at the age of 7 months in the womb. So therefore the struggle begins from the womb. And when the child comes out, again struggle. And he is lying on the bed, some bug is biting, he cannot express, he is crying, and the mother thinks that he is hungry, in this way wrongly understands, cannot give relief him, and he is going on crying, crying, crying. We have seen it, everyone has got experience. Then as soon as he is grown up, he is given responsibility for learning ABCD, or going to school, he doesn't like, no child likes, at least I did not like to go to school. So, this is also another step. Then when he's grown up, he's given more and more responsibility, examination, then married life, then family maintenance, in this way, struggling, 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 again death. Again enter into the womb of mother. Again the same struggle. So where is happiness? Therefore, when Krishna says, dukkhalam asasatam, this whole material world is a place for suffering only. That is a fact. But murayam, being enamored by maya, he does not know. He forgets. This life is a forgetfulness, ignorance. The struggle is going on.